大家好，今天我们来录一录关于 when 的话题。很多英语话题里面，就是一开口看到一个 native speaker 的话，他就可能会问你 How's the weather like？ 不是说他不知道那个 weather 是今天是怎么样，他是可以看得到、享受得到的，只是说他们的开头句可能就是从天气来开始说。然后很多时候呢，你可能会陷入一个很尴尬或者是很词穷的状态，你就会说 Yeah, the weather is good， 然后停了，或者是It's a little bit cold today， 然后就停了，对吧？然后你可以说 Well, it's a good day、we should do a lot more outdoor activities， 或者是你可以说 It's perfect to do outdoor activities， 然后继续把这个 weather 延展到另外一个话题，所以你就不会停留在这个话题里面了。然后我们从、有什么样的一个 weather 去开始说。比如说这个下雨天呢，我们可以称它为 drizzle， drizzle 就是 drizzling， 就是那种外面不是那种下大雨的，只是下毛毛雨。 And then showers, rain, downpour 都是那种大雨的， flood 是淹水。 And then for clouds, if it's a very cloudy day, 很多云的，你可以说 cloudy。 如果是很多云而且很阴的，就是那一天暗暗的， is a very gloomy day。And then foggy 是很那种很多看不到的，就是晚上太冷的时候，在新西兰很多时候在那个南岛，你开车的时候是太冷了，会很 foggy， 很多雾看不到。Overcast 是完完整整那个地方是被那个雾盖淹了，就太多云太冷。Clear 就是没有云，所以这两个 rain 和 clouds 是这两个 category 是常常被用的。有些学生会问我啦，是下薄冰怎么说？它不是 snow， 它是 hail， H-A-I-L。 但是呢，这个如果你可以避免说，就尽量避免，因为很多人可能在发音的时候会停顿一下，或者是在发音的时候会让你迟半拍，就会影响你的流利度了。Another one is about wind. 如果你跑步的时候，你很享受那种风吹来的那种感觉，你可以说 I enjoy the breeze when I'm running, or I miss the breeze from the ocean. 就是海边吹过来的那种风。Hurricane 是比较严重的，就是那种打风的。OK。还有 temperature, we can talk about the temperature is pretty hot or the temperature is pretty warm. Freezing, the temperature is freezing. 这不是说那种零下的，当我们说 I'm freezing right now, 就是真的真的真的很冷，就是比较夸张一点的一个形容词。Another one is 很多人在这个 weather forecast会忘了其实它是什么意思。其实它就是一个 collocation， 当你搭配 weather 加 forecast 的时候，就是预期，不是预期，是天气预报。 OK， forecast 是去 predict something， 对吧？所以他问你 Do you watch weather forecast， 然后你就可以回答 yes or no， 然后加个补充句。 OK， and rainbow 大家都会知道嘛，就是那个彩虹。And drought 就是没有雨的，就是很干的，然后可能一整个月都没下雨，那就会变成 drought 了。 Alright, so let's move forward to some practical phrases. So if it's really really hot or you want to talk about it's quite warm out there, so you can 用这个词去形容一下。 It's pretty hot out thereWhat's the temperature like? 所以加了这个 pretty 的时候呢，去形容一下外面蛮热的，所以这个中文蛮可以用这个 pretty 去代替。然后另外一个方式呢，比如说你今天很忙，然后你不想出去， I'm pretty busy today, I don't feel like going out. 所以你不想去直接说 I'm very busy, 那种很僵硬的，你可以说 pretty, 就是温和一点的那种语调。 Another one is we talk about perfect weather.上次我的那个 car journey 就会用了这个 perfect weather. It was a perfect weather for outdoor activities. It's not too hot or not too cold. It's very comfortable. 所以这个 perfect weather 也可以代替为 comfortable weather. It was a comfortable weather for outdoor activities. Okay? 所以不一定要说 the weather is good for
outdoor activities， 这个 good 可以变成 perfect or comfortable， 还有这个可以变成 the weather is perfect for outdoor activity， the weather is perfect to do something， alright？So another one is let's talk about climate change. What do I mean by climate change? In here, climate change 就是那种四季的气候转变，所以 climate 就是气候，然后加一个 change 呢就是气候转变，所以它是一个 collocation， 就是 band descriptor 里面说的 use more collocation and changes of four season， 它是比较短语。一个短句子。 So where I come from, the city that I grew up is called Kuala Lumpur, which has only one warm season, and we don't experience too much of a climate change. 所以它那个气候是蛮稳定的。We will experience a comfortable weather all year round. 然后你可以再加这个，就是全年可能都是一样的。 So all year round.And then another question is, do you prefer one warm season all year round, or do you prefer four seasons in a year? 然后你可以说 well, personally speaking, I prefer the changes of four seasons, 就是换另外一个方式去回答四季的变化。This is because 什么什么东西 okay? 可能in each season, it canbring us different excitement. For example, in the winter, we can go skiing. In the summer, we can go to the beach. Or in autumn, we can just take a walk in the park. It's really comfortable, 对吧？所以可以继续的延展。So I prefer the changes of four seasons. Or, I grew up in a city that has one warm season. So I prefer the changes of four seasons. I could experience different activity in each season. So let's move forward to about feeling. If the weather affect your feeling. 所以我们可以用这个三个词组，比如说 under the weather. Under the weather, 你就想象一下有一个很大片的那种乌云在你头顶上面，然后会让你觉得啊，我要生病了，我就要感冒了，太冷了。OK? Feeling blue.那个 blue 这个蓝色呢是很忧伤的，就是很伤感的一个颜色。所以如果 native speaker 说 I'm feeling blue today， 就是代表他今天无精打采，有点沮丧的，有点不是很开心的。 So raining cats and dogs， 这个要如果是以 image 来看呢，它就像这个一样，就是很多很多猫猫狗狗跳下来的。 OK， 但是呢它这个俚语呢不是说很多猫猫狗狗掉下来，它只是说 It's raining heavily, okay? That is a heavy downpour. 刚才我们学过的 raining 可以用 downpour, okay? 然后我们看看怎么去用这三个。所以我刚才说了，如果是下大雨的话，或者是外面天气不好的话，我都会觉得无精打采，好像要感冒的。最近这一周我真的是感冒了，然后呢我的声音也一直变很一直在咳嗽，一直在发炎的。 So when it's a rainy day, I always feel under the weather. It makes me feel blue and lazy to do anything. So 我的mood is affected by the weather. And sometimes it can be raining cats and dogs, 就是下大雨。 Weather like this can affect people's mood, especially if they plan to do any outdoor activities. So this sentence is perfect to answer, do you think weather can affect people's mood?So, yes, of course, I think weather can affect people's mood, especially if it's a rainy day and some people have some plan to do outdoor activities, this will definitely affect their mood, 对吧? Okay? 或者是如果你要以自己做例子, well, take me for example, I always feel a little bit blue when it's raining. I feel lazy to do any day. But...If it's a sunny day, I feel a little bit more active and I would go out and do some outdoor activity. For example, running or jogging in the park. 对吧？所以你可以用这些例子去代替一下你要延展的那个下一句。所以六分以上的学生呢，记得评分标准说过了，你需要有一个长度的答案，所以不要说的那么短，继续的去延展。好，今天就是留给你们一个小作业，就是 Tell me about your favorite weather. 把你们的 comment 留在那个小作业里面，让我知道你们最喜欢的一个季节或者是一个天气是什么。 OK, thank you.